Hello students, good morning to all. I hope all of you are fit and fine. So today we are going to study the new chapter, that is soil. Okay, so let's start. So all of you have seen the soil everywhere and surrounding to you, and we are using soil in different purposes. So soil is used for different purposes, and this soil is we are using in our day-to-day life. Okay, so this soil is what? The soil is a natural resources which is used in our day-to-day life for different purposes. So let's see. First we'll study about importance of soil. So we'll study about importance of soil, then we'll study how soil is used, means here, then we'll see the different types of soil, different textures of soil. Okay, so let's see importance of soil. So importance of soil. So soil is used in different places and for different purposes. So let's see where soil is used and how soil is used. So first is what? Importance of soil. Soil allows the growth of plants. The plant is growth in soil. So it supply water. The soil supply water, nutrients and the water nutrients to the soil, so that the plants will grow. So soil is the main part of agriculture. For agriculture also we need soil. Okay, so this soil is need in for agriculture, and means the farmer produce different types of crop. So for different types of crop we need different types of soils. Next is different types of soil. Without agriculture, food, shelter, clothing are not possible. Okay, so without this, you cannot get food, shelter and clothing. This is our basic necessity of life. Next, many microorganisms live in soil, and other organisms also live in soil. Like this, look, earthworms, some beetles, all these live in soil. Okay, and that is the home for or habitat. Okay, of these small organisms. Then underground water is also used for various purposes. Okay, so the underground water which we get from soil, that is also used for our different things, day-to-day things like drinking, cleaning, washing, all those things, or even in agriculture and even in industry also. Then engineering medium means all the engineering means making buildings, making factories. Okay, and making different things, we are needing the soil, and this soil is important for our day-to-day life. Okay, next we'll see that different types of activities are given here. So what are these activities and how these are affecting the soil? So look at here, different types of activities are given, and these activities are polluting the soil. So look at, we'll see how these are polluting the soil and how can we control this pollution. So dumping non-biodegradable substances such as plastic bags, polythene causes soil pollution. So when we dump means when we throw the non-biodegradable substances like polythene, plastic bags. So non-biodegradable substance, they cannot degrade or destroy easily, and they cannot be mixed with soil. That's why it causes soil pollution. Then waste products like from industry. Waste product from industry that contain chemicals. These chemicals can affect soil adversely. Means they can change the texture and quality of soil. So when soil's quality or texture is changed, so we cannot use that soil. Okay. And that causes pollution. Then excess use of fertilizers and pesticides pollute the soil and decrease fertility. Means we cannot grow crop on that soil if we use excess of fertilizers. Okay. Next, what we'll do? to reduce the soil pollution or to stop the soil pollution, dumping anything, before dumping anything waste into soil, it must be treated properly. So we'll see if for non-biodegradable substances we cannot dump the non-biodegradable substance in soil, then excess of fertilizers and pesticide cannot be used. That should be used minimum quantity. We can use, instead of this, we can use the organic manure and organic pesticides. Next, lastly, materials like mesh plastic should be banned. If for plastic and polythene are what? Those are non-biodegradable substances. Now that has been banned. Still some people are using, still we are also using. So we'll use this minimum, or this should be banned, so that our, because it is affecting, polluting the soil, and if soil is polluted, that will affect the living organisms also. So with all these activity like leaves and grass clippings, swimming pool chemicals, hazardous chemicals, soaps, detergent, trash and litter, okay, animal waste, dirt, oil, other oil and other chemicals from car, air pollution, pesticides, fertilizers, all these are polluting the soil and it will affect our life hazardously. That's why we'll reduce the soil pollution. Next we'll see soil profile. So what is soil profile? And we'll see the soil consists of different layers, and this is called soil profile. So look at here, what you are seeing here, you can see the layer of soil, and this layer of soil are known as, each layer of soil is known as horizon. So first is A horizon, next is B horizon, then C horizon, last one is bedrock. So these layers are, layer of soil is known as horizon. But from A horizon to bedrock, this vertical layer of soil is known as what? This vertical layer of soil is the soil profile. So let's see the soil profile. The soil consists of distinct layer, and these layers are known as what? Horizons of soils. So the soil profile is what? Vertical section of soil, what we have seen in the previous picture, the vertical portion of soil and where layers of soils are present. So how we'll see this one? When we'll go to deep, or when you will dig soil for making well or foundation of wintering or laying foundation of building or making any pond, what we can see? We can see different layers on that soil, and that layers produce, that layer is layer horizon of soils, and those, all these layers, we can say that soil profile. Next we'll see, we'll find humus. Where is humus? Humus is what? The dead decaying matter in the soil, means dead decaying organisms are, that will produce the humus. Those are known as humus in the soil. Then weathering. Weathering is what? Weathering means breaking down, or you can say that destroying. The soil is formed when rocks break down. So when rocks break down, or when rocks break down due to rains or flowing water or winds or temperature, means high temperature or low temperature or other climatic conditions, like if there is hailstorm or there is cyclone, okay, or there is flood, like this type of climatic condition, that will weather the soil. Weather the soil means break the soil and make it into powder, and this weathering causes, this weathering produces what? Soil. Next we have parent rock. Parent rock is which? From where rock soil is formed. So the nature of soil, that is its texture, okay, and availability of minerals depend upon the rock, okay, from which it is formed. The in soil we'll find the soft texture and many minerals in soil. When the rock has rock is soft and the rock has minerals, but if rocks has very less minerals, the soil which is formed from that rock will have very less minerals. So parent rock is what from which the soil is formed. So this is about our soil profile, you can see. Okay, so next we'll move to, we'll see the different horizons. Let's see the different horizons of soil. So layers of soils, or layers are horizon A, horizon B, horizon C, and last one is bedrock. So let's see what are there in these horizon. So first horizon is, that is top horizon, that is horizon A. This is also known as top soil, and it is visible to us. We can see. Okay, it contains large amount of humus minerals which makes dark in color. So top soil is dark. You can see here the color, it is dark because it contains humus and minerals in large amount. Then because humus and minerals are present, that's why it is rich in nutrients. So much nutrients are there. Then soil is soft texture. So if you will touch, then you can find it is soft and it can retain water easily. So if you will touch, then you can find it wet. Why? Because it retain water, means retain means hold. It hold water easily. That is why all the plant roots grow in topsoil region. So most of the root you can see in topsoil region. And also the topsoil is home to many living organisms like insects, worms, beetle, rodents and moles. These live in topsoil. Next we'll go to B horizon. B horizon is done as middle layer. So it is next layer of soil which does not contain much humus, means it contains very less humus. So very less humus means you cannot very less humus means it is not rich in nutrients, but it has minerals. Okay, it has minerals. Large minerals are found in large quantities. Then this layer is hard texture and light color because it contains very less humus. That's why it is light texture, and large minerals, that's why it is hard texture and more compact in than the topsoil. Here this is more compact. Okay, next bedrock. The lower one is what? Sorry, the third one is what? C horizon, or that is third layer. Third layer of soil consists of small rocks with crack on them. Thus in this you can find small rocks, and here you can find the cracks. These rocks are partly weathered. These are means partly broken. Okay, next we'll go to last, or that bottom one, that is bedrock. The last layer of soil is bedrock. It consists of large pieces of rocks. You can find here large pieces of rock that is not weathered, not exposed to wind or water. Okay, next, bedrock cannot be dug with the help of spade. Spade means in Odia you used to say kodalo. Okay, so with the help of spade you can dig the A horizon, B horizon also, a little bit C horizon also, but this cannot be dug. Okay, dug means tome yaku kholi parivani kaha dwara, kodalo dwara. So it is because it is very hard in texture, because here only you can find rock. Okay, that's why it is known as bedrock. So this is about layers of soils and what we are find in layers of soil. Next we'll move to next slide, how soil is formed. Okay, so let's see how soil is formed. Okay, so when we know the soil is formed, when by weathering of parent rock. And the texture of soil depends on the parent rock only. So how is the parent rock? Like that you can find the soil. So if the process used to take time, means hundreds of years. Okay, so we are polluting or we are destroying the soil in a moment. But if the soil means soil is produced for 1 centimeter of soil, for producing 1 centimeter of soil, it takes hundreds of years. Okay, then only we can find the soil. So in first stage of soil formation, the soil is generally non-porous in nature. Non-porous means water cannot enter the soil. Okay, that is non-porous. And then it slowly turns into water and air. Turns into soil having the air and water in the pores. Okay, then slowly there pores will be formed where the water and soil will enter. Okay, then we can define a soil as a mixture of rock particles and humus, means when after that dead and decaying organic matter that will enter the soil, newly formed soil, and that will produce humus. Based on size of particles and texture of the soil, it can be divided into various types. So here you will see first one is bedrock, then it is disintegrated, or here it is broken into pieces. Here cracks and crevices you can see because of different weather. Weather means different climate, either raining or hailstorm or high or low temperature, or your flood or cyclone. This causes the breaking down or weathering of rocks. Then after that, the mineral fragments or organic matter enter the soil, and also air and water enters the soil. It produces humus and it produces the horizon slowly. Then you can find the top layer of soil, which is useful for growth of living beings. And you can find different layers of soil, that is A horizon, B horizon and C horizon. Okay, so this is about how soil is formed and how you will using the soil. Okay, next we'll see different types of soil. So here you are seeing different kinds of soil: clay soil, loam soil, sand and silt. So let's see, explain what are the different types of soils are there and what are their uses. So first one is what? First one is our sandy soil. Okay, first one is sandy soil. So look at here. So this is sandy soil. Has sandy soil, sandy, from sandy you are knowing it has more sand. So it has big particles and large spaces between them. So spaces between these are filled with air. And sandy soils are well aerated soil. Well aerated means you can find air, more air in this soil. So because of large spaces, water can easily penetrate. Penetrate means go inside and pass through the soil. Okay, through the particles of sand. Sand soils, however, cannot hold water because water can easily pass, easily penetrate from one part to other part. Okay, that's why it cannot hold water. And sand soils are light aerated and dry in nature. Those are light aerated, means air is present, and dry because it cannot contain water. It does not become moist. That's why it is dry. Sandy soil lack nutrients. It does not have nutrients, and here we cannot grow. Here we cannot grow the plants, and here animals are not living. Okay, next we'll see, means it does not support different growth, means we'll grow some plants but not different kinds of plant. Okay, next we'll move to clay soil. Clay soil means clay. You have seen that clay is used for making different types of our murti. Okay, you are producing that murti. Tumhe murti jo taiyari karcho, and different types of different types of monuments, in mud, we are producing from clay. We can make pot. Okay, pot is also made, different types of clay materials like toys are made. So those, that is made from clay, and this clay help to making so many things. So we'll see what is that clay. That's clay containing soil is clay soil. So clay consists of fine materials which have less space between them, very less space. There is not much space for much space means not well aerated like sandy soils. Not much space means air cannot enter. Okay, the tiny gaps between the particles also allow absorption. Okay, of water in clay soils easily. Okay, there water is absorbed. Then they are able to hold water. Okay, here water can be held and are suitable for growth of different kinds of plants. So here different kinds of plants can be grown. But in sandy soil we cannot grow different kinds of plant. We can grow only few types of plant, but here we can grow much more kinds of plants, and this can hold water. Okay, so this is about our two types of soil, that is sandy soil and clay soil. Next we will see that loam and silt. So let's see, loam soil is loamy soil, and silt, which contains silt, that is silt soil. So let's see what is this loamy soil. Loamy soil contain similar amount of large and small particles in them. So here it is not containing very small particles, or it is not containing very small particles, medium particles, and it has equal quantity, means you can see same quantity of large and small particles. So they are the combination of sandy, clay and silty soil. So here you can find it is the combination of sandy, clay, silty soil. So it has the property of all these soils. So this also contains humus. Humus means it is fertile and you can grow so many things, so many crops. They can hold water in appropriate amount. Okay, and therefore support the growth of plants. So this is known as agriculture soils, because it has fertility and appropriate texture. That's why it can hold water, it is porous, it is well aerated, and it has humus. Due to this we can grow so many crops. That's why it is known as agricultural soil. So they also contain good amount of calcium, and it has high pH level. High pH level means maintaining pH level, that is acidic. We have pH for acidic and basic. Okay, so it is more acidic. Okay, next, silt soil. Silt soil is what? So silt soil particles are smaller than that of sandy soils, means it has more smaller than sandy soil but larger than clay soils, means it is in between sandy soil. The size is in between sandy soils and clay soils. Silt soil can hold water to some extent because of its fine quality. They are generally found near the water bodies like river banks and lakes. So you can see the soil near to the river bank. Means river bank means what? Jo कौन नदी कूल नहले लेक रे. ओके, ह्रद पाखे तुम जो देखुव मीन्स जो सॉइल तुम पाच, दैट इज नोन ए सिल्ट सॉइल. दे आर रिच इन न्यूट्रिएंट्स, हाईली फर्टाइल एंड आंसर सुटेबल फॉर एग्रीकल्चर. दैट्स वाई दो सॉइल व्हिच आर नियर टू रिवर बैंक्स, नदी कूल जो सॉइल थाए से कौन आम बेसी कौन हुए एग्रीकल्चर हुए. दे आर ओफन मिक्सड व्विथ अदर सॉइल टू इम्प्रूव द फर्टिलिटी ऑफ सॉइल. फर्ट सॉइल रो फर्टिलिटी इंप्रूव करिया पे गोल करा जाए, ताको अदर सॉइल सतो मिक्स करा जाए. दैट्स व्हाई वी कैन डू द फार्मिंग. ओके, सो दिस इज अबाउट योर टाइप्स ऑफ सॉइल, एंड दिस इज अबाउट टुडेस क्लास. आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड, एंड विल फिनिश दिस क्लास और दिस चैप्टर ऑन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. ओके, थैंक यू.